In this tutorial, we will be running folder comparisons using FreeFileSync and examining the differences found between a pair of folders. Start FreeFileSync and open a fresh configuration. First, select the two folders to compare. When comparing folders, FreeFileSync groups files having the same relative path into pairs and then assigns categories according to the selected comparison variant. The default comparison variant considers the file modification time and size. For a slower but deeper analysis that finds bitwise differences, even when file time and size match, switch to the file content comparison variant. Notice how the view type of the middle column has changed. It will now highlight the resulting categories of the comparison rather than show the sync directions. Let's run the comparison. The categories in the middle column show which file pairs have different content and which files exist only on one of the two sides. At the bottom, you can select to hide certain categories you are certainly not interested in. Note that categories hidden this way are not excluded from a later synchronization. You can see that when you toggle the visible categories, the synchronization statistics do not change. Also note that file pairs that are considered equal are hidden by default. In case you prefer different defaults, just change the view filter buttons accordingly. Right-click and save as a new default. Now let's go through the list and inspect the differences. You can open the files on both sides with Windows Explorer by double-clicking on an item. Or open the files with their default application directly from FreeFileSync. Or, in the case of text files, you can use an external text comparison tool to show the content differences. On the left side of the screen, there is the overview panel, which represents a different way to explore the file list. The panel presents all the items that are currently visible as a tree-like hierarchy. It updates accordingly each time the view filters are changed. On the left side of each item, it shows the percentage of the size that the item consumes compared to all the items at the current folder level. So by following a trail of high percentage space-consuming folders, you can quickly find folders that occupy a lot of space or that contain a single large file. After you've inspected all the differences and find that you want to run a synchronization, just toggle the view type shown in the middle column. You can now change sync directions and start the synchronization.